How far do you think you've come in the last 12 months as a player?
Personally, I think I've come quite a way from where I was last time we spoke, but obviously there's still a long way to go. But I'm enjoying the rugby at the moment and enjoying playing, and we'll just have to see where I fit in the squad for this season.
You've been getting involved a lot more with the first team recently. You must be happy with your performances and how it's going for you.
Yeah, it's fantastic to be involved. I mean, this second half of the season I had a bit of a slow start, I had a few injuries and stuff, but it's good to be involved and to push Shawani for his spot. But he's doing quite well, so I'm happy to come off the bench and do my bit when I come on.
Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Congratulations are in order. Are you looking forward to the next couple of weeks with the Saxons, presumably?
Thanks, mate. Really excited to be involved and hopefully, step up another level and prove myself on that stage, hopefully. So, yeah, looking forward to it.
So you're the same position. Is it a case of constructive competitiveness, or do you actually hate him because he's in the team?
A mix of both. I hate him a little bit.
Hate me.
When we used to live together, we'd go through our games together and watch it on the telly back. You'd get us out on the pitch, and it's a different kettle of fish. Like mauling sessions, I'll look for you.
You never find me though. You look for me.
Until recently you lived together, but is it right Alex has flown the coop now, he's gone?
He's flown the coop, but he's got a ring on his finger almost.
Alex Waller keen to return. But he's got a move. A big old immovable object in front of him in James Johnson.
Yeah, there'll be a message coming on here from the coach and staff of Northampton. Big opportunity. First point of call is let's get a penalty from this scrum.
Two and a half minutes on the clock. Potentially the most significant scrummage of Northampton's season.
Yeah, good refereeing, just saying I'm not going to let the ball come in until we're totally set, so no silliness before.
Just over a minute left. Saints are right where they want to be, but why is Myler not back in the pocket?
He's sending them forward now, he's sending them in front of him. Give him some protection.
Just need to be careful that they don't give away a penalty for going off their feet, trying to look after this ball.
Hartley issuing the instructions, a calm head in the cauldron out there. And he's the club skipper who drives it further forwards. Mercy gathers round, Tom Wood is there. And Wood it is who drives onwards. Dickinson. Wrapped up in the
numbers now on the left.
Dowson. Saracens defending as if their lives depend upon it. The Wolfpack is at its finest right now. Myler still not back in the pocket. I think he thinks they need a try. Maybe they'll get one. Burrell. So, so close. Another rings. They're there. Northampton are claiming the try. Dylan Hartley is celebrating. Jim Mallander hardly dared let himself celebrate. They think they've got it.
What an end to the season. Unbelievable.
It'll be tight whether you see it. There's so many bodies in and around the ball.
Yep.
Try yes or no.
Thank you very much.
There you go, Graham. There's one for the end of the season for you. Then you can go to the beach.
George North just raced to the touchline just in case they get a penalty here. But
oh, that's a try. There's his hand. That looks like a try to me. How did it get there is the only question. You can't play it on the floor.
Are we sure it's over the line? On the line?
I think it's over the line, at least on it.
There it is. It's placed. Has it touched the whitewash?
I'm not sure you can give that. It's really tight and it's not. Oh, hang on.
Hold on, that is a try.
There is the best angle he's had.
You still can't tell whether it's touched the whitewash.
I think you can. I think you can see his left hand over the ball. He drives through the middle.
That is a fiendishly difficult one.
I think the angle we saw just prior to that, right at the end of the play, shows that his hand's on the line. And the fact that one of the Saracens players dives in may indicate that they thought it was over the line too. This is such a tough decision.
We think it's Luther Burrell, by the way, who's doing this. Excuse me, Alex Waller. And it's grounded. Saints fans all around Twickenham are celebrating every time they see the ball grounded, but where is the line in relation to the ball?
You've got to keep it rolling on, keep it going, keep it going. Keep it going. I think it's a try. It's incredibly tough to give, but I think it's a try.
JP.
Okay, Graham. I can't tell from that.
I'm saying it's on the line. You may award the try.
Okay, you need to clarify that.
You may award the try. Northampton will be kings of England. Alex Waller is the hero. And the Saints have reached the Holy Grail. Nearly 30 years of waiting is over. What a dramatic finish. It couldn't have gone any further. Northampton throwing off the shackles and reaching the promised land.
Guys, it's been an amazing game. So many unbelievable performances.
A stunning match. You couldn't ask for more drama. And Alex Waller off the bench in the final. It is a fitting finish. He has had a superb season. And spare a thought for Saracens now. Empty-handed after a stellar campaign. They have set the pace throughout, but now they have nothing to show for it. Two major finals and they've come up just short.
Fantastic season for Saracens, but they'll take no heart from that, and it'll be the most difficult summer of all of their lives.
And Northampton finally, after 26 years of trying, this is the one they really wanted. It's in the bag. Northampton are the champions of English rugby.
We're just dragging you away, you're battered, you're bruised. That cut on your eye is not going to feel so bad tomorrow morning, is it?
No, it makes it all worth it now. I mean, it was probably one of the most ferocious games I've played in, and fitness-wise, in the extra half, it really, really took its toll. But I think I'm just over the moon with the win, and it was tough, but the boys,
it looked tough.
Saints have been waiting nearly three decades for, crushed last year. Now Northampton Saints are the champions of England.
When the Saints go marching.
Hi, we're the Lorwis.
Really, partly in some space.
but even further out, George North. Tackled by the Argentinian Cicino, but back to Manoa. The pace and the precision that Northampton are playing with at the moment is unstoppable.
The spread ripped on it. Mapu is out there. They need to ship this. A score worthy of a winger. A score from the man who did it in the Premiership final at Twickenham.
Saints side who scored the try when the Saints got the Premiership title in 2014. We've had a couple of lean years since, Alex. So how does it feel to be back on the podium?
Oh, fantastic. I'm really proud of the young boys that stepped up today. And like you say, that was a long, long time ago since we won a trophy. So good to get another one in the cabinet.
You've got a trophy going, Clay. They're almost waiting for you. Well played. So you crack on. Well played. Congratulations.
Today, a significant milestone. Northampton, Premiership Cup champions.
That signal has been beamed into the Northampton sky.
We're wondering who Bruce
here comes, Alex Waller. Yeah.
My daddy.
Yeah.
My dad. That my daddy. That my daddy.
Breakers in their midst this afternoon.
So today Northampton celebrating one of their most loyal men, the embodiment of this club, Alex Waller, supported by the full family, playing his 300th first team match for Northampton. Amazing longevity and durability and consistency of performance.
Record appearance holders has announced he's retiring at the end of the season. Alex Waller has played 370 times for the Saints since making his debut 15 years ago. He famously scored the winning try as Northampton won the Premiership in 2014. Waller said the Saints had been a massive part of his life after joining the club's academy as a 14-year-old.
On the road, so I've grown up watching these and I know what the support's like. It's fantastic. It's good to be on the pitch.
Alex Waller!
Alex Waller! Beamed into the Northampton sky.
Heading down south to the land of the pines, I'm thumbing my way into North Carolina. Staring up the road and pray to God I see.
You may have walked at Detroit.
I made it down the coast in 17 hours, picking me a bouquet of dogwood flowers, and I'm hoping for Riley, I can see my baby.
For Waller to charge into. Waller accelerating away.
So
Waller is the man who's made it.
Massive highlight throughout his career has been the people that you get to meet and work with, and the lads that you play with, and the backroom staff. You spend more time here than you do with your family. Doing that, your teammates and the backroom staff become an extended family, and you know, that'll be something I miss.
A special moment, is there not, that you can take to your grave? It was injury time, effectively, at the end of extra time. 24 phases, the 100th minute.
I didn't know the clock was up, obviously, because my head was buried in a ruck, and I just saw a small gap in between, I think it was in between Jamie's legs.
They're there! Dylan Hartley is celebrating!
Unbelievable!
Oh, I knew I'd scored it, and I got the nose on the line, and I was like, hey, I hope someone's seen that.
And then 4 minutes while the CMO reviewed it again.
Those 4 minutes were like, please, please.
You may award the try.
And JP blew the whistle in the happy days.
Northampton will be kings of England. Alex Waller is the hero, and the Saints have reached the Holy Grail.
And the dream scenario, Northampton Saints Premiership Champions 2024, might we see some sort of commemorative woodwork?
Yeah, all right, yeah, that's the deal, yeah. I mean, yeah. if we get there and if we win, we'll do something, me and myself and Woody will do something, no problem. I think that'll be a nice little retirement fund anyway, so it'll be all right.
Favourite memory as a Saint?
You got to look at winning the Prem.
Comparing that, lads.
No, I was in the crowd watching. Literally, when you scored it, I was behind the post, literally sitting waiting. What is going on?
Good.
I was 17. I remember seeing you boys. Like, but no, obviously you're 23, 24. I've been like, try so boys like other ones.
And now you're still down. I'm older, yeah. Can you remember your debut for Saint?
It was Ospreys. Way at Newcastle.
Did you break your jaw? I did, yeah, my first out against Coventry. Somebody dislocated my elbow, actually.
Whoever that guy was.
I don't know.
He must have been really, really tough.
How did you end
up? We used to do the most rogue wrestling sessions in pre-season, and it was King of the Rings.
I'd beaten three, and then Sue was my fourth. Landed just off the mat, and they were like, no, reset. And then he picked me up and dunked me, and I put my arm down. Dislocated my elbow.
You're welcome. You missed the whole pre-season.
No.
Back.
Together with his children, Bo and Winnie, this is most likely his last start in the Premiership at Franklin's Gardens. Retiring at the end of the season, this remarkably is his 28th East Midlands derby and his 270th appearance in the Premiership, just a handful to go. But a moment to enjoy for Alex Waller.
He's played an incredible amount of games, and to right, score a try, wander off, take the plaudits. Fair play, Alex Waller. A try that won the Premiership final back in 2014. And a try to round out the last game of the regular season at this place he's called home for so long. He'll be back once more in the semi-final.
Yeah, it was at least 60 metres out. I don't know if you saw the chicken chase at the end, but I really don't get it. No, it's, what a way to end. Well, it's not the last time going now, but it's been pretty happy with the try.
We could all see the emotion as you came off the pitch, but it's not the end. But was it starting to sink in at that point when you were leaving the field?
Yeah, I was just hating it. Yeah, no, definitely, the support's been fantastic and it's been like, well, I'm just about left there and, so I just said I'd have a minute, but I'm back now, I'm all right.
I'm going to make you cry, yeah. You're a local man, like Corny, you've grown up with
with capturing Wellington School. This has been your club, Monlanan boy. Is it possible to tell everyone, you know, what this black, green and gold jersey means to you?
I'm just going to put it into words, but it's been, you know, it's been the major part of my life for the past 20 years now. I've been involved since I was 14 here at the club. And you know, to be a long-time man throughout my career was something that I wanted to do and something that I'm proud of. And I grew up as a Saints fan, watching the likes of some of the lads I was fortunate to play with, and suddenly now, you know, I've got over 350 caps or whatever it is, and you know, I've loved every minute. It's been one of the biggest sort of honours of my life to pull this shirt on, and yeah, I'm definitely going to miss it, but time for some new challenges in the new season.
And I can see your family over there, and it's a big day for the whole Wall family, because I mean, it's special for you, I suppose, to be bowing out with Ethan at the same time.
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, you might almost. it's been a massive privilege to share this journey with Beef, and to have the support of my family, Harley, Bo, Woody, and the rest of the crew. It's been, you know, I wouldn't have been able to do it without them. And it's rugby's a very selfish job at times. It's been nice to have Beef involved, someone that truly understands the ups and downs and the ins and outs of rugby, to be able to bounce ideas off and share your thoughts with someone who, you know, has your best interest at heart. But rugby's a very selfish job, and it's time for me now to put that to one side and focus on something else and give them more time.
And just finally, Alex, you scored one of the most famous tries in Saints history in 2014. Not that one. Have you got another one in you in a Premiership final maybe in a few weeks' time?
Yeah, I hope so. I'm not fussed as long as we win, if we win and just disappear off into the sunset with a bit of mental, just doing those old fast and soft stuff in the old days, and watch these boys for the fun. You know, the squad we've got here is young, myself of course, feel pretty old most days when they're coming, but they've got so much potential to fulfill, and hopefully we do that this year, and I'll be watching from the stands next year, and with all my support and I recommend to go with it and, you know, start up something really special.
Well, let's hope so. Well, it's been a privilege watching you play over the years. All of you, but Alex Waller, it's been a great honour. Good luck for the future.
Thank you.
Huge thanks to Joe and the company.
16 years we've been together. It's a long time. Seen him naked a lot. More times than I care to count. Good ball bag on him. It works as well. Yes, very well. But no, to start out our careers together and to essentially finish them together is quite a rare thing, I think. To see you develop not only as a player, but a bloke, a man, a father, a husband, and to raise your family how you have with your beautiful wife, just makes me happy, bro. What can I say? You have been a rock to all of us throughout the years. You've been someone that we can rely on. And you've been somebody that we can fucking depend on to get stuck in and to lead the way, and I can't tell you how far that goes. I can't tell you how much that gives a team, and we thank you, bro. It has been an absolute honour and a privilege to have spent this long with you, to share my career with you, and seeing how far you've come, and hopefully we can go a bit further.
To the field! No one can stop! last 17 years knocking about this place.
Visualised, and now it's time to deliver. A special occasion and a special venue. The sun peeping through the clouds, and England's finest two clubs ready to go head to head.
A line from Furbank, space opening up, Freeman's in.
Bellerator, and then more speed from Slidehope, good vision as well, into the in-goal area, what a finish! Greece lightning!
I think Alex Waller knows that he's throwing himself on top of this breakdown, just trips in, hangs in there for a fraction of a second, just...
accelerates hard, very quick, very powerful, still going strong, needs the offload, gets it away, Mitchell! The ball is loose, Northampton have it finally! Trophy too. What a moment this is. Dreams come true for three men in particular who've given blood, sweat and tears for the last decade and more. Courtney Laws, Lewis Ludlam, Alex Waller into folklore. Northampton Saints, the 2024 Gallagher Premiership champions.
Time at the end of this season. He has been incredible for us for 15 years. Come on, Sue. Alex Waller! Sue, 15 years with Saints. If you had to write a fairy tale ending of how you'd want your Saints career to end, this has got to be pretty much right there, yeah?
I'll apologise, I've got no voice. I couldn't have asked for more of a fairy tale ending, really. I remember speaking to Ferg around Christmas time and talking about retirement and saying, you know, we could go out with a Prem final as your final game, and we managed to do it. Awesome. Couldn't have asked for a better way to go.
I've watched you over the last three games leave the field around about the hour mark with tears in your eyes, thinking that's the last time you'd be taking to the field with these boys. Yesterday was the last time. What were the emotions? There was a lot going on the pitch at the time, but I had a particular eye on you as you came off the field. What were the emotions as you walked off?
Yeah, I managed to drag out the world's longest retirement. really milked it for all it was worth. I think I got all the tears out, to be honest. I was just a little bit nervous. I had to take myself to the changing room because I couldn't bear to watch for a couple of minutes and just pretend to read the toilet and just disappear. But a lot of relief, very surreal. I think I've had more kisses from Finn Smith over the last 24 hours than I have my wife. Things are looking up. But I'm feeling a bit of relief. It's not sunken yet, it's a little bit surreal. A few more beers, and I'll have no voice by tomorrow, but I'm sure it'll settle in.
Yesterday was phenomenal, of course it was. 10 years ago you scored the winning try at Twickenham, which nobody will forget. How does yesterday compare? You're a little older, a little more miles on the clock. How does yesterday compare to 10 years ago?
Yeah, well, I nearly scored yesterday as well, but Colty went off his feet and beat me for him. it's a completely different experience. Obviously, 2014 just started out on the up. Now 2024, definitely on the down, on the way out the door, just a has-been now, but it's, I couldn't have asked, like I say, for a better, more or less start of my career to win the Premiership, bookend it with another one at the end. I couldn't have asked for more. I'd have liked a few more, but I'll have these, no problem, and a bunch of lads, massive amount of future in this club. I'm going to be, obviously, around still local, and I'll be at the club as a fan now from next season and supporting the boys and hopefully being over there on that side of the fence when the boys win next season.
Absolutely right. What a career, what a finish to an incredible career as well. Ladies and gentlemen,
it shakes the old gear to the bone. No fighter town you'll ever see. No fighter team that ever be. Big city lights don't bother me. No actors ain't side by me. No fighter town you'll ever see. No fighter team that ever be. Big city lights don't bother me. No actors ain't side by me. No! City lights don't bother me, but I just